best, but I think a lot of people would agree that Hellboy is the most, you know, artistically and commercially successful character to be introduced for the past 30 years or so. And into this story, you know, who were all of the influences that he had kept up in a stoppered flask before? Some of it had, of course, trickled out in stories like Batman Legends of the Dark Knight, Sanctum. This is pretty much a proto Hellboy story. You can even see that. This is the cover for the French version, and yeah, for those in the back, my first Hellboy story signed over there. So, what kind of influences are we talking about? Of course, Lovecraft. Some more Sanctum pictures, some show the Gothic influences here. More Gothic stuff. This is also a precursor to Hellboy, you might say. The Bram Stoker's Dracula that Enola did for Topps Comics in 1992. Yes, there he is. Well, Enola poured stuff like architecture, art, comic books and otherwise, film, folklore, literature, occultism, sculpture, as you could plainly see in those quick slides that I showed before. And my text will, of course, not be the annotated Hellboy. We'll have to wait a bit for that, but it will take a couple of volumes. So this is just some traces to the literary side of it. You have an excellent book out called Hellboy's World, Comics and Monsters on the Margins by Scott Yucatman, if you're more interested in the visual side of Hellboy. And yes, how does Mignola approach Lovecraft? We have all read a whole lot of stories, of course, by people inspired by Lovecraft. And we know the usual routine. You name check a couple of elder gods, maybe throw in a grimoire or two. And Mignola isn't a stranger to this as well. This is from the Hellboy Batman Starman crossover. Elder gods, as in Lovecraft Elder gods. Yeah, it sounds weird as it sounds. Lovecraft knew some stuff in response to Hellboy. But usually, Mignola does approach Lovecraft in a slightly different way. There's that as well. Doom the King to Gotham. We all love the pun intended title, of course. But generally, Mignola does adhere to the Cthulhu circle, so to speak, or the Yog-Sothothery, but from a slightly different angle. He likes to make up his own guys, as he says. So instead of having Cthulhu or Yog-Sothoth, he has the Ogdru-Jihad, his elder gods that you see here floating out in the uncanny cosmos. And instead of Johanna Flay, you have the caverns of Lumia Bisk, where Abe Sapien, the place that Abe Sapien goes for. But there are strong connections to the Shadow of Innsmouth, of course. Some more great shots here of the Elder Gods. And to have some more examples of pulp influences here, those of you who like fonts can see that this font is taken from the Doc Savage novels. Yes, Ichthyosapien. And a very different approach to Lovecraft can be found in Alan Moore and Gekman Barrow's Providence, recently. A maxi series of 12 issues that was recently finished. And Alan Moore, as you know, he's a verbose guy. I don't know if you've seen any of his scripts or heard him talking, but he goes for maximum detail in every panel. fills every panel up with guys that you recognize from Lovecraft stories. Have you read Providence? Yeah. So those of you who haven't, it's an intertextual, extremely heavily referenced story about the writer Robert Blake, who uncovers the hidden truth of America, you might say. So he travels through Lovecraft country and has meetings with Alan Moore's analogs for Lovecraft characters.